everyone, welcome back. Thank you for showing up today. My name is Marina. I hope you're staying home and safe. Since most of us have been in lockdown for around 4 weeks now, we're doing a lot of sitting down on our chairs and couches with our hips closed. So today's practice is all about opening up our hips. No props needed, but if you have sensitive knees, go ahead and grab a blanket or a towel just to pad the knees when we get into a low lunge. And when you're ready, come to a comfortable seated position. Tuck your belly in, lift your chest up, roll your shoulders away from your ears, and close your eyes. Start bringing your attention to your natural breath. Feel your chest rising with every inhalation and falling with every exhalation. Breathe softly and naturally. Don't force it. And slowly give your body a quick scan. How are you feeling today physically? Check, how are you feeling emotionally and mentally? Whatever you're feeling right now, just put it on a white, beautiful, fluffy cloud. And let's send that cloud away. And bring your attention back to your breath. Let's inhale and exhale for a few times here. Inhale deeply and exhale. Last time. Beautiful. Now slowly open your eyes. Bring your hands next to you. Lift your arms up, elongate your spine, look up towards the ceiling and take a deep inhalation. As you exhale, twist and open up to the right. Bring your hands down to the mat and slowly open up your chest and look behind you. With every inhalation, try to deepen the fold. And now come back to center. Take a deep inhalation and exhale, twisting to the left. Bring your hands down to the mat, open up your chest, trying to look behind your shoulder, elongating the spine, opening up the chest. And slowly bring your hands back up and come to center and release. Bring the soles of your feet together and bring your heels as close as you can towards your pubic bone. If your knees are very high up and it's uncomfortable, you can either get blocks and books to support your knees or you can extend your feet further. But if you're comfortable, go ahead and bring your heels as close as you can, grabbing the soles of your feet with your hands, opening them up like a book. Lift your chest up, tuck your belly in, shoulders away from your ears. Let's take three breaths here. Inhale for one. Inhale for two, inhale for three, and release. Now we're gonna sit in a cross-legged position, but my left leg is gonna be behind me. So I'm gonna place my front leg, my right leg, sorry, in front, okay? So left leg behind, right leg in front. Take a deep inhalation, lift your arms up, and as you exhale, fold over your legs, making sure that you're folding in the center and you're not leaning towards any of your sides. Make sure both sitting bones are on the mat and slowly bring your forehead to the floor. If this is not available for you, lift your chest up and try to push down with your chest. Do not arch your back, flatten your chest. Feeling a deep stretch in your right hip. And let's take three breaths here.
Inhale for one. Inhale for two. Inhale for three. And slowly exhale
and release. With your right hand, go ahead and grab your left foot, placing it in the crease of your left elbow. Your right arm wraps around your right knee. And go ahead, if this is available for you, interlace your fingers. If you cannot interlace your fingers, you can place your right hand on the knee, cradling your foot with the left arm. Do what's comfortable for you and slowly start rocking your leg from side to side. Make sure that your back is straight, your chest is lifted. If you cannot feel your right hip, and this is too easy, go ahead, extend the left foot, making sure that you're flexing your fingers. Inhale for one, inhale for two, inhale for three, and slowly release, bringing the sole of your right foot down, making sure that it is close towards your pubic bone. Flex the right toes, lift your arms up, take a deep inhalation, exhale, folding over your extended leg. Inhale for one, inhale for two, inhale for three, slowly exhale and release. And now just bring your left leg forward. So we're crossing our legs, and this time the right leg is behind the left leg. Okay? Remember to pull your belly in, lift your chest up, take a deep inhalation, and exhale, folding forward at the center. Feeling the stretch in your left hip. Again, make sure your sitting bones are on the mat and you're not lifting forward. Make sure that you're folding from your chest and not arching your back. Really feeling a deep stretch in the left hip. Two and three. Excellent. Exhale, release. And now pick up your left foot with your left hand. Put the left sole on the crease of your right elbow. And then your left hand wraps around the left knee and interlace your fingers. Again, if this is not available for you, go ahead and keep your left hand on your left knee. And slowly start swinging from left to right, rocking your leg, opening up the hips. Again, if this is too easy for you, go ahead, extend the right foot, making sure that you're flexing. And let's take three breaths here. Inhale for one, inhale for two, inhale for three. Slowly drop your left heel towards your pubic bone, straighten up the right leg, flex your toes, lift your arm up and fold over your extended leg. Inhale for one, inhaling for two, inhale for three, slowly lift up and release. And now we're gonna find our boat. Find your modification. You're either on your tippy toes, and this is fine. You can hold your boat here, release your arms, hold the back thighs. If you're comfortable here, go ahead, lift your legs to 90 degrees, making sure you're not slouching in your back, your back is straight, your chest is lifted up, hold. If this is comfortable for you as well, you can release the arms, and let's take three more breaths here. One, two, engage that core, and three. Now cross your legs, and let's come to a tabletop position. In your tabletop, make sure your index fingers are pointing forward. Make sure that your shoulders are exactly above your wrists and your hips are above your knees. Take a deep inhalation, lift your tailbone up, open the chest, try to look up, inhale. And as you exhale, push the floor away, lift your shoulders up to the sky. It's as if someone is pulling you up from your shoulders, really arch the back, tuck your belly in. Now inhale, move in the opposite direction, tailbone comes up. Exhale, push the floor away, push the shoulders, really engage those shoulders.
Last time. Inhale to cow. And exhale to cat. And then come back to neutral. Tuck your toes and slowly lift your knees up and keep them hovering, engaging your core. Inhale here for one, inhale for two, inhale for three, and now slowly push your tailbone to the back of the room, straightening up your spine, and slowly, slowly start lifting your tailbone up, keeping your knees bent. Make sure, again, your hands are shoulder distance apart, your index fingers are pointing forward, your head is resting in between your biceps, your shoulders are rolled away from your ears, and slowly drop the right heel to the mat, bending the left. Bring your chest to the left knee, feeling the opening and stretch in the back of the right leg. Feel your calves, your hamstrings, your glutes. Open up the back of your leg. Again, straight spine. And now let's change direction. Slowly drop the left heel to the mat, bending the right knee. Chest comes to thigh. Straighten up the left leg, opening up the back of your left leg, and hold. One, two, and three. Slowly pedal your feet. Walk your feet, pedal your feet, and then bring your toes slightly inwards. Heels are out of sight. Drop your heels to the mat, and if you can't, just keep your knees bent and hold your down dog for three breaths here. Two and three. Bring your feet together. Look forward towards your thumbs and slowly start tiptoeing all the way to the top of your mat. Stand your feet hip-width distance apart, grabbing opposite elbows. And just release your head, your chest to the mat and slowly start swaying from side to side. Make sure the weight of your body is not in your heels, it's towards your toes, so you can really engage the back of both legs. So the more you push your weight forward, the more you're going to engage your leg, the more you're going to lift your tailbone up. You can slightly bend your knees here if it's more comfortable. Do and work with your body. And now slowly bring your hands down to the mat, bend your knees, and slowly roll one vertebrae at a time all the way to the top of the mat. Head comes last. Roll your shoulders, one, away from your ears, two, and three. And now let's move in the opposite direction. Roll two, and roll three. Beautiful. Come to the top of your mats. We're gonna do one sun salutation to warm the body. Toes are touching, heels are apart. Lift your toes off the mat. Engage your quads, feel the engagement in your legs, and now slowly drop your toes back down to the mat, maintaining that engagement in your legs. Pull your belly in, lift your chest up, shoulders away from your ears, your fingers are pointing downwards with purpose, palms are facing the front of the room. Take a deep inhalation, lift your arms up, and as you exhale, release and fold forward. Inhale, halfway lift, straighten your back, hands come to your shin bones. Exhale, bend your knees, bring both hands down to the mat. Step back, finding plank. In plank, your index fingers are pointing forward, your shoulders are underneath your wrists. Pull your belly in, hug your inner thighs together, and you're on the balls of both feet. Drop your knees to the mat, push your weight forward beyond your wrists. Hug your elbows in and slowly lift your tailbone up and come down. Chest and chin come to the mat and slide, finding mini cobra. Roll your shoulders away from your ears. Take two breaths here. One more breath. Tuck your toes, finding down dog. Bring your feet together. Lift the right leg up. making sure your knees and toes are facing the mat and not the ceiling. You can point or flex your toes, whatever is comfortable for you. Come on the ball of the left foot. Bend the knee, bring your knee towards your chest and slowly align your shoulders with your wrists. Drop the right foot to the top of the mat. If your foot falls short, that's not a problem. Go ahead, bring your right hand, wrap the right ankle with the right heel, whoop, and push your foot forward. And then slowly drop your left knee to the mat. Find your balance before we come up, making sure knee and heel at a 90 degree angle. Your hips are squared and facing the short part of your mat. Plug the big toe into the mat, really squeezing that, creating the engagement in the front of your left leg, feeling your quads, feeling your hip flexors, and feeling your glutes. Go ahead and lift your arms up, take a deep inhalation. And now I'm gonna ask you to do one more thing. I want you to feel like, or pretend, or try to push the right heel towards the back of the room. Your heel, of course, is not gonna move, but doing that is gonna create even more engagement in the hamstring of your right leg. So pull the right heel towards the back of the room, plug the left toe, really open up and engaging those legs. Two, and three, bring both hands down to the mat. Right arm goes up, simple twist. Inhale for three, inhale for two, inhale for one. Lift up the left knee slowly, grabbing it with the right foot. Lean forward, bring the heel towards your glutes. Slowly look up behind you, creating a small twist and opening up the left quad. You should really feel this in your left quad. Mine is burning, yours should be burning too. Bring your heel closer with every inhalation. And now slowly release, very gently, no sling shot effect. Bring your hand back down to the mat. Step back to plank. Find your plank and align. Push your weight forward. Hug your elbows in. You can drop your knees here and go for a modified chaturanga, or you can go for a full chaturanga here. Flip your toes, coming up to up dog. Roll your shoulders away from your ears, really squeeze those glutes, and slowly lift up, finding down dog. And now bring the feet back together. Lift the left leg up, pointing your toes or flexing your toes, whatever is comfortable for you. Come on the ball of the right foot, bend the left knee, bring it to your chest, and as you bring it to your chest, align shoulders above wrists, drop the left foot. Again, if it falls short, not a problem, go ahead and grab your left heel with your left hand and push it forward. Drop the right knee, untuck the toes, find your balance first, and then come up. Make sure knee above ankle in 90 degrees, your hips are squared. Lift your arms up, push your belly in, lift your chest, and again, plug the right toe into the mat, really engaging and opening up your right hip flexors. Push the left heel towards the back of the room, engaging the left hamstring. Hold, two, three, and four, bring both hands down to the mat. And now slowly lift your left hand up with a simple twist. Let's take three breaths here. Two and three. Slowly lift up the right leg. Go ahead, grab it with your left hand. You can lean forward. Heel comes towards your glute. Rotate with your chest. Look behind you or towards the ceiling. Really engaging that right glute, opening it up. Let's inhale for three, inhale for two, inhale for one. Slowly, slowly release. Bring your right, left hand down to the mat. Step back, find your plank and
a line. Index fingers are pointing forward. Push the floor away. Engage your belly, your inner thighs, and slowly push your weight forward. Hug your elbows in. Drop your knees or go for a full chaturanga. Flip your toes. Lift up, up dog. Roll your shoulders away from your ears. Engage your glutes. And slowly lift up, finding down dog. Let's take a few breaths here. Two and three. Bring your feet together. Look towards your thumb. Come to the balls of your feet. And slowly start walking your hands to the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Straighten your back. Your hands come on your shin bones. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come all the way up. And exhale, release. From here, we're going to come to the top of our mats. The right leg, we're going to bring the right heel over the left thigh, hands in prayer mode, go ahead and squat down. Hold for five, hold for four, hold for three, hold for two, hold for one. Slowly come back up and then release the left leg, bending both knees, slowly with control, step back with the right foot, finding high lunge. In your high lunge, again, knee above heel, hips are squared and facing the narrow part of your mat. Really lift your kneecap up, engaging your quad, engaging your glutes. Do not let your heel slump towards the mat, keep it lifted. Engage your core, lift your chest up. Inhale, lift your arms up. Take three breaths here. One, two, and three. And then slowly open up. Warrior two. In warrior two, make sure the right leg is at 90 degrees. So the edge of my right foot is parallel to the short part of the mat. I'm engaging my quads, I'm engaging my inner thighs. My core is engaged and my pelvis is facing the wide side of the mat. Lift your chest up, lift your arms up and gaze between your left middle fingers. Inhale for three, for two, for one. And now I want you to pulse. One, pulse for two, pulse for three, pulse for four, pulse for five. Drop the left elbow to your left thigh and slowly swing the right arm above your head and slightly twist with your chest looking up. If this bothers your neck, then you can just look forward. Inhale for one, inhale for two, inhale for three. Slowly lift up, bring your toes to point in parallel. So the toes are pointing toward the corners of your room. Bend the legs, finding goddess. You can cactus your arms or you can have your arms in prayer mode, whatever is comfortable for you. We're gonna hold for three, for two, for one, and then we're gonna pulse for one, pulse for two, pulse for three, pulse for four, pulse for five, and let's hold it one more time. Two, three, four, and five. And now I want you to try to lift your heels up and come a little lower. Yes, one, I know it's burning. Two, three, four, and five. Beautiful, drop the heels down, finding Skandasana on the left side. Toes and knees are pointing towards the ceiling. Your left hand is coming inside the left knee. Open up through your chest. Lift the right arm up. Take three breaths here. One, two, and three. Bring both hands down to the mat, switching to the right side. Again, toes, our knees are pointing towards the sky. Right hand comes inside the right leg. Slowly open up with your chest. Lift your left arm up. Take two And three breaths here. And slowly bring your left hand down. And let's swivel, finding runner's lunge on the right side. Put all the weight on your right foot. And step to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Straighten the back, hands on the shin bones. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come all the way up. And exhale, release. Now we're going to repeat the same sequence, but on the left leg. So, come to the top of your mat. Left heel comes towards the right thigh. Bring your hands in prayer and slowly squat down and hold. Hold for five. Hold for four. Hold for three. Hold for two. Hold for one. Slowly start lifting up. Release. Bend both knees. Left leg slowly, slowly with control. Starts moving back towards the back of the mat, finding high lunge. Again, make sure your right knee is above your right ankle. Your hips are squared. You're lifting through the left knee, engaging the quad and your glutes. You're on the tippy toes of your back foot. If your heel slouches towards the mat, go ahead, bloop, lift it up. You can widen your stance. You can shorten your stance. You can even take a step outside if you are having a hard time with your balance. Most importantly, keep that back leg engaged. Pull your belly in, chest up, lift your arms up, and take a few breaths here. Inhale for one, for two, for three, slowly opening up, finding warrior two. My left leg swivels and is at a 90 degree. So the edge of my left foot is facing the short edge of the mat. My right leg is still bent. I'm opening up through my inner thighs. Take deep breath, engage your core, lift your chest up and extend your arms. Gaze between your right middle finger and hold. Hold for one, hold for two, hold for three, and now let's pulse it. Pulse one, pulse two, pulse three, pulse four, pulse five. Beautiful. Drop the right elbow towards the right knee. Swivel the left arm above your head slowly. Opening up your chest. Rotate with the chest towards the ceiling. Look up. Again, if this bothers your neck, you can look forward. Take three breaths here. Inhale for three. Inhale for two. Inhale for one. Slowly come up. Again. Make sure your toes are pointing towards the corners of the room. And deep. And bent. Finding goddess. Let's try to bend even deeper than we did in the first on the right leg. So, again, you can cactus your arms. You can bring your arms in prayer. Whatever is comfortable for you. And let's hold for five, for four, for three, for two, and one. And now let's pulse. One, pulse for two, pulse three. Can you come lower? Pulse four, pulse five. Lift the heels up, lower it down, slower, lower, lower, lower. My legs are burning. I'm starting to lose my balance. Hold five, four, three, two, drop those heels, and let's find Skandasana on the left leg. Point your toes towards the ceiling. Left hand comes inside the left leg. Lift the right arm up, open up your chest. Take three breaths here. One, two, three. Bring your hand back down to the mat and slowly swivel to the other side. Left toes are pointing and flexed towards the ceiling. Right arm inside the right leg. Open up with the left. Three breaths here. One, two, and three. Slowly swivel towards the front of your mat. And now I'm going to ask you to step back to your plank. Hold your plank and align. Hug your elbows in. Push your weight forward. And now slowly, very slowly, with control, one breath at a time, the slowest chaturanga, all the way down to the mat. Bring your hands on your forehead, Let's take a few breaths here. Inhale for three. Inhale for two. Inhale for one. Bring your hands underneath your shoulders and slowly lift up your chest, keeping your pubic bones on the mat. Hold one, two, three, and four. Lower it down. Forehead comes to the mat. Widen your arms. Let them come to the sides. And now slowly lift your chest up. Pubic bones stay on the mat, feeling a beautiful bend in your back. Roll your shoulders away from your ears. Squeeze your glutes. Tuck your hip bones again inwards towards the mat. Three, two, and one. Slowly come down. Bring your hands underneath your chest and come to a wide-legged child pose. So, knees are on the edges of your mat, toes are touching, and slowly finding child pose. Take a few breaths here. Inhale for four, for three, for two, for one. Inhale, look up. Exhale, release. Cross your legs behind you and come on your back. Walk your heels towards your glutes, making sure that your heels are touching your middle finger, not closer so you don't have an awkward bridge. Your knees and your toes are in like a train track, pointing in the same direction. Hands come down to the mat. Take a few breaths here and now lift up. Lift your tailbone up. You can shimmy your shoulders, opening up your chest and your throat. Really squeeze those glutes, opening up the thighs. Interlace your fingers behind you. Let's breathe here for one. Breathe in for two. Breathe in for three. Breathe for four and five. And slowly release your arms. And start dropping your heels back down. Sorry, your glutes back down to the mat. I want you to pull your core in to close the gap that's in your lower back. Relaxing your back. Bring your knees to your chest. Swing from side to side, massaging your spine. Three and four. And from here, you have two options. You can either diamond your fingers and bring them underneath your glutes and lower back. Lift your legs up in 90 degrees. Flex your feet and you can hold this position for the next 20 breaths. If you have a shoulder stand, go ahead, find your supported shoulder stand. Take 10 breaths here. Inhale for one, inhale for two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. And if you can, slowly start dropping the right foot towards the mat, toes are touching the floor. Do not look to the right or to the left. Make sure your neck is straight. If you feel any pinching of your neck, come out of this pose. And now slowly start dropping the left toes towards the mat. Release your arms. Straighten your knees. Take a deep inhalation. Inhale for one, for two, for three, four, and five. Slowly bend your knees. Grab your outer hips and slowly come down one vertebrae at a time. Bring your spine towards the mat. Hug your chest in. Take three breaths here. You can massage your spine from right to left. Open up your knees.
Lift your heels to the mat, grabbing the outside of your feet. Push your knees, come inside your shins. Push your feet or your knees towards your armpits. The heels are pushing towards the ceiling. Your toes are trying to come to your face. Really releasing the back and the hips. You can swing from side to side or you can keep this position. Three, two, and one. Bring your knees back in towards your chest and now drop them towards the left, making sure they're in line or above your hips. Cactus your arms and look towards your right side. We're gonna take five breaths here. Inhale for two, last breath here. Come back to center, hug your knees in, and now drop them towards the right side and open up your chest, look towards the left. Five breaths on this side. Three, two, and one. Amazing. Come back to the center, give yourself one nice hug. Maybe lift your nose towards your knees. And now slowly release your legs. Extend your legs, opening them up, letting them drop to the sides. Release your arms, palms are facing towards the ceiling, your fingers are lightly curled. Finding Shavasana, sealing our practice. Try not to skip this pose. This is very essential. It is when the brain is registering all the practice and the poses and the asanas that we just went through. To sealing the practice. Close your eyes. Surrender to gravity. Completely melt into your mat. Relax your jaw, relax your shoulders, your chest, your belly, your hips, your thighs, your toes. Focus on your breath. Feel your inhalation and exhalation. If any thoughts pop into your head, just acknowledge them and put them in a beautiful white fluffy cloud and send that cloud away. If you have a to-do list, put it on the cloud. You can always come back to that list. Your day, your kids, your spouse, your work, everything can wait. Enjoy the next minute. Focus on your breath, feel your inhalation, feel your exhalation, let the rhythm of your chest rising and falling be your guide to quieting the mind. They say that we store all our bottled emotions and unresolved issues in our hips. Every hurt, every rejection, every pain we've ever felt is locked in our hips. And as we do hip openers, we are slowly unlocking and releasing some of these deep embedded scars or pains. And as we are releasing them in our practice, we're feeling lighter and happier. But we can always get more emotional. So if you're feeling emotional today or tomorrow, just enjoy the fact that your body is releasing all these bottled up poisons that were sitting down locked in your hips. And now when you're ready, just bend one knee at a time and come to your right side.
Come to your fetal position and give yourself a nice big hug. Reminding yourself that you are safe, you're secure, and you're loved. And use your left hand to push you up to a seated position.
And slowly come to a comfortable seated position with your eyes closed. And bring your awareness back to your natural breath. Take a moment here to thank yourself for showing up on your mat today. Reminding yourself that yoga is not just a physical practice. It is the practice of kindness and love. So please take kindness and love with you everywhere you go. Today, every day, on your mat and off your mat. And let's release any negativity that we might be bottling up. Let's live in this world carrying lighter baggage. And now take a deep inhalation through your nose. Open your mouth and release. Let's inhale love. And exhale anger. Let's inhale confidence. Let's exhale self-doubt. Let's inhale positivity and exhale negativity. And slowly and gently open your eyes. Thank you for joining me today. Namaste. I will see you next time. Have a beautiful day. Bye.